Britain, the rise of paganism, of green men and policemen, resurrecting the old religion.
Much blather about devil worship, political correctness gone mad, and the destructive effects of unchecked individualism greeted the announcement on July 16th of an official association for pagan policemen to take its place alongside the existing Muslim Police Association and a recently created equivalent for Sikhs. But for Britain's Druids, Wiccans and witches, it was another precious inch gained in a quiet struggle to get society to take them seriously. No one is quite sure how many pagans there are. The most recent census, carried out in 2001, counts 31,000, but others take a broader view. Ronald Hutton, a professor of history at the University of Bristol, has studied membership lists of various druidical orders and witch covens and reckons the true figure may be somewhere between 120,000 and 200,000. That could place pagans between Buddhists and Jews, respectively the sixth and fifth largest religious groupings in Britain. One reason for the confusion is that pagans are shy, fearful that their devotion to pentagrams and the ancient Semitic god Baal will be misinterpreted as devil worship, or simply worried about being mocked. Many choose to hide their affiliation. The 2001 census included 390,127 self-described Jedi Knights, inspired by the characters in Star Wars. Many are thought to be pagans in disguise. Another reason is that pagans are an ecumenical bunch, welcoming those who worship a variety of pre-Christian pantheons, Celtic, Germanic, Greek, and plenty of others, as well as druids, witches, and fuzzy spiritualists with a fondness for the countryside. The strongest themes are romanticism and a reverence for nature. That helps to explain paganism's appeal to characters as diverse as the poet Percy Bysshe Shelley, who was rumoured to keep an altar to Pan, a priapic pre-Christian fertility deity, and Kenneth Graham, the author of The Wind in the Willows, an Arcadian children's fantasy. Despite the difficulties of definition, paganism has slowly been winning recognition from the authorities. It is not only pagan coppers who are finding their place in the sun. Pagan prisoners are now allowed to have religiously themed possessions, wands for instance, and in 2006 the Home Office approved a pagan oath for use in the courts, "By all that I hold sacred." There are still difficulties. The Pagan Police Group's website contains a discussion of the law on indecent exposure and the difficulties this poses for citizens who prefer to go skyclad, i.e. naked. And Britain has a way to go before it catches up with countries more recently Christianised. Ása Trúa Félagið, Iceland's pagan organisation, for example, was officially recognised in 1973 and is a beneficiary of that country's religious taxes.